السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the all-knowledgeable and the all-wise. O Allah, teach us that which is beneficial, and allow us to benefit from that which you have taught us. You are the all-knowledgeable and you are the all-wise. We'd like to start off by making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he grants us safety and security. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he protects the first responders. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that whatever tests, trials, and tribulations that we go through, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't let things affect our spirituality and our iman. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qalbi ala deenik. Ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qalbi ala ta'atik. O the one who changes the hearts, keep our hearts firm on your faith, keep our hearts firm on your obedience. You know, it can be overwhelming, all the news that's going on, and you know, don't give in to the negativity. Stay positive and be grateful for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessings and make dua for others. You know, I've been having conversations with people in other parts of the world, and you know, we are here in the United States, and we are here in Chicagoland area, and there's you know, self-isolation or stay-in-place orders, but people in other places of the world, basic necessities aren't being met, so please make dua for them, and we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he takes care of them and allows them to be healthy and allows them to get whatever they need during this hard time. You know, just a reminder to myself and to all of you, stay home during these days, you know, help slow the spread, flatten the curve. Everyone has a role to play, and this is something that we need to continue. And some of the physicians, they actually reached out to me, and they said that just let the people know that it's very important during this time for people to not worry too much, not stress too much, because that will affect the immune system, and to make sure that people are eating healthy and, you know, getting whatever type of exercise that they can get. So please make sure that you're staying active. Make sure that you are not reading news that's going to be depressing and demoralizing. Stay at home, but stay physically active and make sure that you're eating healthy. So then, inshallah ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help this be a means of protecting us and keeping us safe and healthy. You know, alhamdulillah, you know, we want to always be focused on making our primary goal and our objective the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is something that, whether in moments of happiness, moments of sadness, moments of prosperity, moments of adversity, we see in the method of the Prophets, alayhimus salatu wassalam, that they worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every situation, every circumstance, and we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he allows us to do the same. The last few weeks, alhamdulillah, we've been talking about the importance of the messengers, alayhimus salatu wassalam, and those videos are available on Facebook Live, so if you missed the last few sessions, you can go back and check them out. And the first week we talked about how the messengers, they help guide us to answer the essential questions of life. Like, why were we created? If we were created to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the purpose of our creation, how do we do that? And what will happen if a person, what will a person get as a result of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Right? And what will a person get if they refuse to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? All of these questions have been answered by the messengers, alayhim salatu wassalam. And then we talked about the roles of the messengers, right? What do they do? What is the purpose of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending the messengers besides answering these essential questions? They're role models, right? They help us and guide us to that which is most beneficial in terms of our dunya and our akhirah. They help us live life with a purpose and direction. They help ourselves, they help us and help us help ourselves and help others come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and overcome challenges and obstacles. And we all have this responsibility to follow their teachings and carry on their message to others. So tonight, inshallah, we're going to be talking about the example of the first messenger that was sent to people who were opposing him and see how he responded. So Nuh alayhi salam is the first messenger that was sent to the people of earth. Right? And the ulama say, okay, what about Adam alayhi salam? What about Sheth or Seth alayhi salam? Nuh alayhi salam, he came to a people that were oppositional. And that's how some of the scholars, they distinguish between a messenger and a prophet. prophets, right? They come to people, and for the most part, the people accept their teachings and follow their teachings. A messenger is a person who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose and gave revelation to, that comes to a group of people, and the people confront them, they're oppositional, they don't believe in them, and things of that sort. So Nuh alayhi salam was the first messenger sent to the people of earth, and this is mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At the day of judgment, people will go, right? There'll be people waiting for the judgment to begin, and the people will go to different prophets and say that, you know, praise them and ask them to intercede and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to start the day of judgment. And one of the things that they mention about Nuh alayhi salam is that you were the first messenger that was sent to the people of the earth, right? So this is why we say about that. So all of the things we discussed the past few weeks in terms of the roles of the messengers, in terms of the purpose of the messenger, we can find a real example of those roles in action with the story of Nuh alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the beginning of Surah Nuh, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم He said, إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ أَنْ أَنذِرْ قَوْمَكَ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ Indeed, we sent Nuh alayhi salam to his people, saying, Warn your people before there comes to them a painful punishment. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ إِنِّي لَكُمْ نَذِيرٌ مُّبِينٌ أن يعبدوا الله واتقوه وأطيعون. Nuh alayhi salam said to his people, O my people, indeed I am a clear warner to you, saying, Worship Allah and fear Him and obey me. يغفر لكم من ذنوبكم ويؤخركم إلى أجل مسمى إن أجل الله إذا جاء لا يؤخر لو كنتم تعلمون He told them, Allah will forgive you of your sins and delay for you a specified term. Indeed, the time set by Allah, when it comes, will not be delayed if you only knew. So what did he do? He called them to a very specific message, which is the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. He also told them to follow the Prophet, follow him as a messenger. Follow him because he is a messenger and will guide him and show them how to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he warned them against the consequences of turning away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All the luxuries that you have right now, they're only temporary. But when the time set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you comes, nothing can prevent the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala coming upon people. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protection, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all refuge. In Surah Hud and Shu'ara, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned some of the reasons that people refuse to follow and believe in Nuh alayhi salam. And these reasons are the same reasons that people refuse to follow and accept the teachings of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Mecca. These are the same reasons that people refuse to accept the teachings of Islam now. And sometimes even in our own families, in our own communities, we have people that will use the same arguments. So it's very important for us to understand and learn and how to respond to these things. In Surah Hud, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فقال الملأ الذين كفروا من قومه ما نراك إلا بشرا مثلنا وما نراك اتبعك إلا الذين هم أرابلنا بادي الرأي وما نرى لكم علينا من فضل بل نظنكم كاذبين
So the rich people among them, right, who disbelieved from his people said, right, so the rich, powerful people who disbelieved from his people said, we do not see you except as a man like ourselves. And we do not see you followed except by those who are the lowest, right? And they are people who don't have the intellect, aren't intelligent, the low class of society. And we do not see you that you have any merit over us. Rather, we think that you are a liar. So what did they say? They said that we see you as a human and you're no better than us. And they said that the people that follow you are from the lower classes of society. They don't know any better. They are foolish. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in Surah Ahqaf, that the mushrikun used to say to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كَانَ خَيْرًا مَا سَبَقُونَا إِلَيْهِ They said that if this is something which is good, the kuffar used to say to the believers, that if this is something which is good and truthful and good, you would not have gotten it before us. Meaning the sense of entitlement. So as we mentioned, this was a recurring theme, and the same arguments were used to, by the mushrikun of Mecca to try to discredit the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the same arguments are used to, for people to try to take away from Islam today. Oh, look at the Muslims, they're foolish. Look at the Muslims, they do this and things of that sort. And this is what they used to say about Bilal radiallahu anhu. Right? Why should we follow you when Bilal radiallahu anhu follows you, Ammar follows you, and the people that they thought were among the lower classes of society? And we have to be careful of such arrogant attitudes and such arrogant mindset, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us all. Even though there may be people in society that get overlooked and neglected, they may have value with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And having value with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most important thing that a person can have. And that is not based on gender. That is not based on nationality. That is not based on race. But it is based on submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and following the example of the teachings of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and by following Allah's commands and staying away from his prohibitions. So Nuh alayhi salam in Surah Hud, it also talks about how Nuh alayhi salam, you know, told and tried to talk to his people and convince them. And one of the things he said is, وَيَا قَوْمِ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ مَالًا إِنْ أَجْرِيَ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ وَمَا أَنَا بِطَارِدِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّهُمْ مُلَاقُوا رَبِّهِمْ وَلَكِنِّي أَرَاكُمْ قَوْمًا تَجَهَلُونَ. They said, oh my people, I'm not asking you for any wealth. I'm not asking you to pay me or give me things. My reward is only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I am not one to drive away those who have believed. Indeed, they will meet their Lord, but I see that you are people that are behaving ignorantly. And he said, وَيَا قَوْمِ مَنْ يَنْصُرُنِي مِنَ اللَّهِ إِنْ تَرَدْتُهُمْ أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. And oh my people, who would protect me from Allah if I drove them away? Then will you not be reminded? So if we mistreat people, right, because they don't have financial status, they might not be, you know, in the inner circles or the higher circles within society, but they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we mistreat them, right, it's because society might not value them or respect them, who's going to help us in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when the heaviest thing on the scales will be the iman of a person and the character of a person, not their bank balance, not their which nationality they come from, not which language they speak, not which type of food that they eat, but their iman and taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Nuh alayhi salam, in Surah Nuh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned different strategies and tactics Nuh alayhi salam used to call people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? And he mentioned that قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي دَعَوْتُ قَوْمِي لَيْلًا وَنَهَارًا فَلَمْ يَزِدَهُمْ دُعَائِي إِلَّا فِرَارًا. He said, my Lord, indeed I invited my people to during the night and the day, but my invitation increased them only in them running away from me. And he said, وَإِنِّي كُلَّمَا دَعَوْتُهُمْ لِتَغْفِرَ لَهُمْ جَعَلُوا أَصَابِعَهُمْ فِي آذَانِهِمْ وَاسْتَغْشَوْا ثِيَابَهُمْ وَأَصَرُّوا وَاسْتَكْبَرُوا اسْتِكْبَارًا. And he said, indeed, every time I invited them, that you may forgive them, O Allah, they put their fingers in their ears, and they covered themselves with their garments, meaning they didn't even want to see me. And they persisted in arrogance, and they were persisted in their arrogance. Then he said, right, ثُمَّ إِنِّي دَعَوْتُهُمْ جِهَارًا ثُمَّ إِنِّي أَعْلَنْتُ لَهُمْ وَأَسْرَرْتُ لَهُمْ إِسْرَارًا. He said, then I invited them publicly. Then I announced to them and also confided to them secretly. So if you look at the methods that he used to call people during the day. He used to call people during the night. He used to call people publicly. He used to call people privately. He used whatever means that he had to call people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their own benefit. Even though people were putting their fingers in their ears, people were trying to cover him, not see him, people were trying to run away from him, he was always persistent in trying to call people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he spoke about, what was he calling them to? What's the methods that he was using? Yes, he used a lot of different strategies, but he talked about the benefits, right? He talked about the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would bestow upon them. He said, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. And ask forgiveness from your Lord. And indeed, he is the one who forgives over and over again. And what happens when you seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us all from anything that we've done that's major or minor, intentional, unintentional? There's benefits associated with istighfar. He said, يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send rain from the sky upon you in continuing showers. And He will increase you in your wealth and your children, and provide you for gardens and provide for you rivers. So making istighfar, right, from this ayah, you see, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring blessings from the sky, will increase people in blessings such as children, wealth, worldly luxuries such as gardens, things that we can benefit from. Then he tried to reason with them, right? So he talked to them about the positive. Seek forgiveness from Allah. He'll forgive you and He'll bless you, and even in terms of your dunya. Then he tried to reason with them. Why don't you worship Allah? He does things that no one else can do. Right, and among the blessings that he mentioned that are only exclusively the domain of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that no one can say that anyone has any authority in these matters except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created people in stages. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who created the sky. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has complete control over the sun and the moon. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who caused vegetation to grow. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who made the earth stable and firm for us so that we may be able to travel with ease. He said, مَا لَكُمْ لَا تَرْجُونَ لِلَّهِ وَقَارًا وَقَدْ خَلَقَكُمْ أَطْوَارًا. He said, what is the matter with you that you do not attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the grandeur and the respect that He deserves, while He is the one who created you in stages?
أَلَمْ تَرَوْ كَيْفَ خَلَقَ اللَّهُ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ طِبَاقًا وَجَعَلَ الْقَمَرَ فِيهِنَّ نُورًا وَجَعَلَ الشَّمْسَ سِرَاجًا.
Do you not consider how Allah created the heavens, seven heavens in layers, and the moon? He therein reflected light and made the sun as a burning lamp. Right? In the terms, you look around the sky and you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation. And the only one who has control over that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you look down, then He says,
وَاللَّهُ أَنْبَتَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ نَبَاتًا ثُمَّ يُعِيدُكُمْ فِيهَا وَيُخْرِجُكُمْ إِخْرَاجًا.
Then Allah is the one who has caused you to grow from the earth, a progressive growth, right? When He came, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused us to grow. And then He's going to return us to the earth as well and bring us out from the earth as well. That's why when we bury the individuals, we put the dirt on them and say, مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. And we put the dirt, we say, from it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, from it we have created you, to it we will return you, and from it we will resurrect you. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all a good ending and give us safety and security when we're resurrected in front of Him on the Day of Judgment. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said,
وَاللَّهُ جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ بِسَاطًا لِتَسْلُكُوا مِنْهَا سُبُلًا فِجَاجًا.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made for you the earth as an expanse, made the earth vast for you. And then He's made that you may follow their roads of passage and made it easy for us to travel. Despite Him doing His best, right? How did the people respond to Him? It's not that He called people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a short period of time, for a year or for a few months. In Surah Al-Kabut, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ إِلَّا خَمْسِينَ عَامًا. That He called to the people to 1,000 years minus 50, except for 50. So 950 years He called people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at the end of the 950 years, right, after Him calling restlessly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, calling people during the day, calling people during the night, calling people publicly, calling people privately, and He had people that talking about the benefits, talking to them about the harms, all of these things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا آمَنَ مَعَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ, that there were only few people that believed in Him and followed Him. Right? The closest members of His family did not believe in Him, but He did His best and kept doing whatever was within His capacity to do the right thing. And that's all we are required to do, is to do our best. So there are certain things that we don't have control over, right? But when we do our best, inshallah, we can stand confidently in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, oh Allah, I tried. And this is something that we want to remind ourselves, that there are times that we will be tested with those that are closest to us. Right, inshallah, next week we're going to be talking about how the son of Nuh alayhi salam, did not accept Islam and did not follow him. And how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that the wife of Nuh alayhi salam did not believe in him. But alhamdulillah, he did his best and he's not responsible for that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests us sometimes through those that are closest to us. So what's our responsibility is that we need to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to continuously do whatever we can. And we'll talk next week inshallah about how he built the ark. In spite of insults, in spite of taunts, in spite of people coming and talking to him and that what are you doing and making fun of him, he did what he had to do. And alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he guided some people towards him, but the results are not in our hands. So we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he gives us all the ability to do our best in every situation and circumstance. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he gives us the ability to persevere and to be persistent and dedicated to doing whatever is within our capacity. Never lose hope in brothers and sisters, my brothers and sisters. Right? There are people that might be very close to us, very dear to us, that may be doing things that are displeasing and harmful to themselves or harmful to others and harmful in the relationship between themselves and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be like Nuh alayhi salam. Make dua for them. Try to call them. Try to be there for them. This is a perfect time to reach out. Right, to call them and not necessarily talk to them or talk to them about Islam, things of that sort at this time, just ask them how they're doing. Keep that relationship up. Right? And this is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did until the last day, until the last seconds with his uncle Abu Talib. He said, just say La ilaha illallah. And Abu Talib did not say La ilaha illallah, but the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam never stopped trying. So never lose hope in people and do your best to call people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in whatever capacity that you can. Inshallah ta'ala, next week we will complete the story of Nuh alayhi salam and talk about how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him and those that followed him and those that made the choice not to follow him, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dealt with them. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through his beautiful names and his glorious attributes, he protects all of our iman. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gives us the ability to follow the examples of the prophets alayhi salatu wasalam and stay dedicated and committed. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, anyone going through any type of hardship, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaces that hardship with ease, comfort, and support. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let us all be a means of bringing ourselves and others closer to Him. Jazakumullah khairan. And subhanaka wa bihamdik. Nashhadu la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Take care, everyone. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.